I was really nervous about you and Sunny.
I mean, because I knew how dangerous he was, but on the other hand, he was so good to me and Stone, you know, and you were crazy about him, so it didn't seem to matter. What?
I went to such extreme lengths to manipulate him into asking me to move in with him.
What are you doing?
Sit-ups.
Well, I figured this. Why?
Because I do 100 sit-ups every morning.
Oh, man, since when?
Well, I didn't think it was the most romantic thing to do when I used to stay the night over.
So, what happened to romance?
Well, we are going to be waking up every morning together from now on, so I figured I should get back into my regular routine.
I had these moments with Brenda that I couldn't believe, because she would do anything to be with me.
I bet you never admitted it, though, right?
Well, you know, it was too cool. But I gotta say, she scared me a lot, because she was demanding, insecure. And I said things to her that I'll always regret. But like I said, when it was good, it was good.
Sunny more than I've ever loved anyone in my whole life. He was my whole world. It was a little more complicated for him. He was very secretive. I mean, he still is.
I know. Funny, because now I understand having to keep secrets, but back then I just couldn't wrap my brain around it. Didn't matter, though. I still thought nothing would ever stop us.
Do you think it was fate?
Yes. I did. I just felt so important when I was with him. The first time ever, just felt like I mattered. Like he was that person, you know? That person? The person who loves you forever, no matter what.
I'm sorry, going on and on.
No, it's okay.
Well, you don't want to hear about, you know, me and other women while you were raising our son and Benson.
Sonny, you didn't know, because I didn't tell you.
If I had known, you know, I'd have been there.
I know, but then you never would have had Brenda. And I wouldn't have got to raise Dante exactly the way that I wanted to. And as it is, we've got a fabulous son that we can both be very proud of. I'm really happy that you feel you can confide in me. Like this. I don't think I've ever seen this side of you before.
Well, you know, I can't really explain it. I've had, you know, a lot of beautiful women, including yourself, of course. No, I mean, I used to own a strip joint. Mm-hmm. So I could have had, like, a lot of girls, you know.
Yeah, but something was different about Brenda. You know, what set her apart?
Well, she was spoiled. She was, you know, rich. She lived a privileged life, treated it like it was nothing.
And you just had to prove that you were good enough, right?
Well, I started that way, and then it became a lot more, you know, because I couldn't believe that I could feel that much for somebody. And then she gave me her heart and soul, and I couldn't get enough.
You know, Sonny, I really like getting this little Thank you. A glimpse into the middle of your life. Of course, I knew you so well when we were growing up, and I know you now. But everything that happened in the middle was always kind of a mystery to me.
Well, you're probably better off. Because when I left Benturner's to go to the Paradise Lounge, mm-hmm. it was not my finest hour. Mm. I was going down the wrong road. And I didn't know at the time that when they shut down the Paradise Lounge that it would be the best thing for me because I was right in position to take over for Frank Smith when he died.
Right.
And it's the first time I got a taste of serious money, real power.
All right. Force to be reckoned with, as they say. Yeah.
And Brenda was with me through all that. Mm. And then we lived in this, like, apartment over Luke's club, right? Mm. It was quite the setup. Right now it just seems like it's cliche, but, it was probably the best place I ever lived.
I can see it right now. I see some shiny sheets, a lot of smoked glass, black leather, a little chrome.
Yeah, chrome everywhere. So much chrome that if you looked at it, it would blind you. And then it had, like, a dimmer for the lights to set the mood, right? Candles and all that kind of stuff.
Sweet.
It's very slick because I was pretty slick when I was young.
Yeah, you're still pretty slick.
Brenda saw right through all that. You know, she wanted the best for me. She expected me to have more. Basically, if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't be who I am.
We just had so much fun. You and Sunny and Stone.
I know. We did.
The good times definitely outweighed the bad times.
Yeah. I think that's why it's so easy for me to romanticize Stone, you know, because we didn't have time to experience the bad.
Yeah.
We didn't have to make any hard choices because, well, the biggest one was made for us, so all there was left to do was have fun and love each other. Do you remember our first double date when we lied to my Uncle Mac and then we went to Sunny's apartment?
We were cool then.
We were cool then. And I started drinking, and I remember Sunny didn't say anything.
And Sunny cooked, and the food was ridiculous.
It was. And then he sent Stone on some errand in the middle of the night to the post office. I mean, it's so obvious now what was happening, but I was clueless back then.
You guys fell for that? That was so cute, because that was his big plan for me. He always has a big plan for me.
And do you remember the night that Luke's Club opened? It was like everyone in Port Charles was there.
Yeah, and what happened to Luke's Club?
Luke apparently trashed the place and then there was a fire.
And what happened to Sunny's old apartment?
The building's still standing, but I don't know, I think it's gutted.
He always loved that apartment, you know? He said he'd never leave it. I guess he did.
It's kind of sad when you think about it. You know, it's like a memorial to a time when all of us were really happy.
Yeah.
Hey. Any update on the Balkan?
Spinelli's still looking for information. This whole thing is going way too slow.
How's Brenda?
She's, all over the map. She's complaining about everything. I won't let her go jogging in the park. Imagine that. Seems like she's getting upset over just little stuff now.
Yeah, you know, I know how she gets. She gets wound up and she doesn't want to think about what, you know, she doesn't want to think about, which is the Balkan.
Or being back in Port Charles.
Yeah, like when we were together.
To say to you right now.
I'd like to know about your connection with Dante Falconeri. I know you met him in 2007 when he was guarding you, a fact that neither of you saw fit to tell anyone, which in itself speaks volumes.
Does anyone in this town know the definition of personal boundaries? I don't want to be questioned about Dante because it's absurd. Sonny is Dante's father.
What does that have to do with anything?
Why do I always feel like you're attacking me for something?
That is not my intention. I just want you to realize that sometimes you react without thinking things through. Sending Dante away the way you did before is not a good idea.
Well, it doesn't matter. I just had Jason get him reassigned.
Brenda, he's a good cop. You need protection. He's doing a good job.
I'm not comfortable with Dante.
Why? Because he's Sonny's son?
Because it's none of your business. And every time I see Dante, I think of Sonny.
You know, sometimes I think about Brenda. Like, I'm on the docks. And I see her with, you know, when I first met her, she had that suitcase. Max gives me a ride in the car. I look out the window and I can see her and Robin laughing like when we first met. You ever notice that she leaves the coffee cups half empty?
Yeah, it drives me nuts. She still does it.
You know, I don't know when it was. It was past midnight one night and I told Max to pull over the car. And I stood outside, I don't know, maybe waiting to see her.
I'm sorry.
Listen,
I thought the best way to stop the Balkan was to bring Brenda back here, and she told me not to. She said it was going to hurt too much, but I couldn't see any other way.
That's not your fault. You're protecting her.
Yeah, but I see what it's costing both of you.
I just think sometimes if things were different, if I didn't tell you to go to the church that day, what would have happened, you know? Like, would we have a family? Would we be, you know, sharing a life together?
Take inside.
Oh, thank you so much.
You know what? The place is pretty burned out. I don't know if you should walk in there by yourself.
Could you just wait here? I'll be okay. You know, I mean, it's been standing for so long. I doubt it's gonna fall down tonight, right?
I don't like this.
Yeah, but you could just stand right by the front door, and you have my cell phone. I have yours. It'll be fine.
Look, Brenda, I'm supposed to stay with you. Okay. All right. Just if anything happens, you make sure you call me. All right?
Yes, I promise.